This tutorial will look at how to configure and manage the responses you get from your Google Form. The whole reason for creating a Google Form is because you want to collect data, what Google Form calls responses. And there are a couple things that you need to consider when setting up a Google Form. Up here in the menu bar, there's this option, Choose Response Destination. When you click on this option, Google wants to know where do you want it to send the responses that it collects when people take your Google Form. The end data that you collect is going to be dumped into a spreadsheet. And Google Form wants to know what do you want to call that spreadsheet. In this case, by default, it copies the name that you gave your form, but then in parentheses puts responses to let you know this is where the data from your form is going to be dumped into. You also can put this into another or existing spreadsheet if you've already started one. You can even put it into a sheet of another spreadsheet. In this case, I want to keep this data separate from other forms I've used, so I'm going to keep it in this digital footprint responses option. You do have the option to keep the responses only in the form itself, but that restricts how you can use the data afterwards. So I recommend using a new spreadsheet, using the name of your form, but with the extra tag responses. Notice now it is setting up that spreadsheet to collect the responses from this form when I decide to go live with it. Now that it has created the form, this has changed to a quick link that will actually jump me to the spreadsheet where the data will be stored. Let me go back to the form now. The next button says accepting responses. This comes in handy if at one point you want to stop collecting responses or disable the form so that you can analyze the data. For example, if you're going to collect responses from one group and you want to wait before collecting additional responses from another group. In the case of students, if the deadline for filling out the form has passed, you can turn this off and prevent students from taking the form in the future because they've missed your deadline. Finally, in the toolbar, there's a link here where you can quickly jump and look at what your form looks like. Unfortunately, my form is not available because, if you recall, I had just stopped accepting responses. So let me go back. Let me accept responses again. And now let's click View Live Form. So here's how the form looks like so far, even though I haven't actually created anything yet. So remember, once you've got a form started, you want to set where the responses are going to be stored, decide whether or not you want the form active or not, and then if you ever want to see what your form is going to look like to your audience, you can view the live form here. This concludes this tutorial.